and welcome in to the Fun Astrology Podcast. Thomas Miller on Friday, June 19th. Boy, do we have a lot going on today. Let's talk fast. I guess, is this rally with President Trump going on? Boy, I'll tell you what, he needs an astrologer up there in that office. I'll tell you, at least it's happening the day after the moon wobble peaks, but it still is in the moon wobble period. So the moon wobble has nothing to do with the moon. It has more to do with the nodes of the moon. What it is three times a year, sometimes four, the sun conjuncts or squares the nodes of the moon. All right, so the north node and south nodes of the moon are, of course, directly opposite each other. Think of that as a line across the chart. When the sun either conjuncts the north or south node, that sets up and fires off this concept called moon wobble. And then when the sun squares that axis line, then that also fires off the moon wobble. So it happens about, it's almost the same time period as Mercury retrograde. It's 80-something days that it happens. This one happens to be a conjunction between the sun and the north node of the moon. Now, that officially happens at 6:28 p.m. this evening. How you calculate the moon wobble is you back up 21 days prior to the conjunction or the square. So that takes us back to May 29th, and that's the day that these riots began following that horrific situation in Minneapolis. But I mean, look at the ripple effect of this. Look at all that's happened. You know the news. I don't need to recount that. But it is just amazing that this all happened under this period of time that is called a moon wobble. The person who I learned about this from, this is very not mainstream. Moon wobbles are not considered mainstream. And the person that I learned from has been studying it for decades and has tracked that when this period happens around these aspects to the nodes of the moon, the sun and the nodes of the moon, that earthquakes, volcanoes, stuff like this, you know, just it's all kinds of, that over the years has proven to be true. Now, the moon wobble peaks, and then it goes into a waxing period for just 7 days. So yes, tomorrow's rally in Oklahoma will be under the moon wobble. At least it will be in a waning phase of it. Now, the other thing that I would be a lot more have my eye on, again, if I were a fly on the wall in the Oval Office, I would say, well, you know, Mr. President, there is an annular solar eclipse in Cancer on Sunday, and you're having it on the summer solstice. Are you sure you want to do this? But, you know, one observation I have about Donald Trump, the man does not have a chart. It's like he defies astrology. So I don't know. We will see. But June 21st, yes, Sunday, is the next solar eclipse. This, of course, on the heels of June 5th's lunar eclipse, and also on the heels of Saturday's sun ingress into Cancer, which, of course, is the summer solstice. I'll have to do podcasts over the weekend. We just got too much going on, so we'll talk about that on Saturday. But yes, back to the eclipse. The eclipse is on Sunday, and the sun is in Cancer. Now, for us in the United States, this is going to be an overnight thing. Again, this is similar to the lunar eclipse. This is going to appear basically in the Far East, areas of China, India, Africa, that part. Timeanddate.com always has really good information. Space.com has good information on this. And NASA, of course, covers them as well. And nowadays, you can see them on YouTube. So if you want to get up at 2:40 in the morning Eastern time and see the peak, you will be able to see the ring around the sun. It is a cool event. Oh, I'm telling you, it is amazing. So here are the times. All, of course, Eastern U.S. It begins at 12:47 a.m., on June 21st, Sunday morning, early. It peaks at 2:40. The last location to see it will be at 4:32 a.m. And just to throw another wrench into the gear here, the sun, which will be at 0 degrees Cancer, having just ticked in there on Saturday, will be in a quincunx, that's 150-degree aspect, to Saturn, which is at 0 degrees Aquarius. And then if you wanted to throw another one in, because the sun has only moved one tick off of its conjunction with the North Node, they're basically sitting there together. And they are in a degree-based square with Mars. So when you have the nodes of the moon square to a planet, that's called a bending of the nodes. This happens a lot, actually, and a lot of astrologers don't point it out. It's one of the first things I look at because Saturn sits on the bend of my nodes, go figure. But yeah, this has Mars at the bend of the nodes. And basically what that does is it makes that planet, I'm trying to think of the right analogy, it's like the royal family watching the parade go by kind of thing, right? It's an overseer making sure that everything's okay, initiating and stepping in if something is needed. Then the planet sitting at the bend of the nodes will definitely get on the court and take action. So it's not just a participant or it's not just an observer. It can also be a participant. A very, very important concept. All right, there is enough going on. Let's leave it there. At least that sets the stage for the next couple of days. And then we will dissect this with podcasts over the weekend because this is quite an alignment and series of 1, 2, 3, boom, boom, boom energies in the sky. All right, thanks so much for listening. We will see you again tomorrow. We'll do short ones over the weekend, but we will touch base. All right, have a good one. Take care. Bye-bye.